Now to wait for the thing to actually show up. Button show up.
There it is.
At some point, the button will actually register. There we go, finally.
Yeah, it showed up way faster.
At some point,
for
the
me,
button will actually register.
Odd.
Whatever. Around on a thing. Okay, good. Just making sure.
The adventure game.
Well, that was from last week.
That's cool.
Okay.
I'll be right back.
I just realized I was trying to interact with the meager window inside of this OBS, which is, of course, not going to work. Oh, boy. Jesus Christ. A flight simulation game from 1983 on DOS. Oh, boy. This is going to be the best game ever made.
I'm sure it'll control... just wonder.
Oh, I'm sure it will.
You play it on cassette.
Oh, it wants a random number seed. What the fuck? What the fuck
Hot
is this
war.
Shit? I have no idea how to actually do anything. Okay,
flight
legal commands
simulator.
Are CO to change course. AL to change altitude. ST to get a status report. Oh, Jesus. It's a text adventure game. Oh, my God.
Drop the barum.
I love the
Phoenix.
Way it goes to have autopilot fly plane. That's great.
Launch Phoenix missile.
I have no idea what the fuck they're talking about. Let's try ST. Oh, it has to be capitalized.
Yeah. Big.
Alrighty, so what have we got here? Kind of
we got absolute trash.
Text adventure thing.
What was the commands again? Okay, change to so CO 164.5. Oh, 164.5. So now ST. Okay. So now
you're going to Sevastopol, aren't you? A working joke.
This is incredibly terrible.
Actually, I think about, shouldn't Archlon be here? For going to Sevastopol? He's gonna help you with all those aliens. I heard a boop. It's a wizard!
Hello.
Hi. Bell, is this game just too good?
Oh man.
Can't handle it.
Oh wow, this is...
This, I mean, I know it's giving you constant text updates, but it's really giving me a poor idea of where I'm actually at in flight mission.
This is the best game involving Sevastopol.
This is literally... We effectively do have to time the arrival. So...
Is this in real time?
CO-163. Now... AU. Oh my god. The fact that you cannot backspace, by the way.
Oh. Why would you want backspace? Computers can't do that.
Oh, hey, we have an enemy.
Launch a Phoenix missile.
That's what I'm going to do. Target,
do a barrel roll.
Okay, it is out of range. What was the command again? So then we want to EC. Okay, we have used ECM and the SAM that it launched died. So, NA Sevastopol.
Self-destructs. Why did your SAM 5 self-destruct?
That's their SAM because oh. I used an ECM thing to counter the SAM.
Never mind.
Okay,
I missed where they launched.
Oh, I don't blame you because this is real good.
At least it's easy to bring up.
Okay, we have more SAM. So, the solution to SAMs is to use electronic countermeasures.
I thought it was to use
missile. No, not the SAM site, Koopo! The actual missile self-destructed. Because the ECM meant that the SAM can't target it anymore, so it blows up. Oh, Jesus.
Getting sand, don't you need to use Mr. Frodo?
Okay, we are 2,000 kilometers away from our target.
Ah.
So.
Now it says you're 2,100.
No, I used EC. EC is electronic countermeasures. No, EV is evade. Because, God forbid, there be actual sensible shit.
Why? You wouldn't use a barrel roll.
Anyway.
That's only in Star Fox. You're supposed to adjust your speed behind.
NA, or AU.
Real fight.
I'm going to give it 120. Okay, Talon Base is now in Phoenix range. So, sure. Talon. Okay, we blew up the Talon defense complex because, sure, why not?
It's not Sevastopol.
Well, I'm blowing up the defense complexes on the way to Sevastopol so that I get less missiles.
Yeah.
So, also, I like that they can launch missiles which will take, I think, 1,200 seconds to get there, because that is totally a sensible thing to do.
They saw you from a while away.
Well, the problem is more, I don't think surface-to-air missiles exist that could be flying for 1,200 seconds, because that's 20 minutes of flight time on a SAM, which is a bit absurd. Oh my god. Okay. So AU 120. NA Sevas. Oh, I can backspace here, but I can't. I can backspace here, but I can't backspace when it's doing the numbers. Sevastopol. We are 1,700 kilometers away now.
Better have like, when you win, it better have like some fancy graphic made up of print period.
I still love the way it's got Sevastopol. That's still one of my favorite things. In that, for some reason, when it's displaying the text right there, it's got an extra space for no good reason.
It's the Sevastopol Bears.
AU 120. NA Sevastopol. So I'm literally just autopiloting for short periods of time so that I know when we're going to get there. You would think that is... I would agree, Sylphie, except that these are surface-to-air missiles, so they will have to burn for a fairly long period of time in order to actually get up. We are apparently a high-altitude bomber.
Maybe they're being launched from, like, Middle Gear or something.
Pinsk base is in Phoenix range. Sure, why not? Let's... Phoenix-Pinsk. Okay, we blew up Pinsk. They didn't actually do anything, but we blew them up anyway.
They have a dumb... weapon. Phoenix, away!
We got 1,000 kilometers to go. Oh, we have Kiev in bomb range. But let's just keep going. Because we're trying to get... Because the primary target is Sevastopol, and I don't know if we have...
Is there a way to list...
List more bombs. I'm assuming that we have only one bomb, because they have an arm bomb and then drop bomb. So I'm going to guess that we have two of them. So, anyway, let's see. Do we have no context on radar.
I think it tells you how many you have in status.
It tells me the number of Phoenix missiles I have. Six 600 kilometers to go.
Have Australia fly your plane for you.
We're at 4,500 kilometers per hour. So, let's give it another 4 minutes.
Just asking, how did you know how you put it automatically goes to the target if you keep putting it on autopilot? Or did you have to tell it what?
Well, I've already set the actual
Oh. Not a...
We had a whole bunch of SAMs launched, so we ECM'd them and they all went away. So, I mean, get into the call, Sylphie. Why aren't you in this? Okay. I have no idea.
Sophie's getting ready to go to bed.
Okay, Sevastopol is in bomb range now.
Finally!
So...
Help. Arm that sucker.
AR.
Because I'm assuming something bad will happen if you
now
drop it without
somehow
arming
remember
it.
The failsafe code, which I don't even remember. It was all the way at the beginning of the game.
Oh, I didn't. Well.
Whatever. We see how it works. I guess it's a game, if you want to be real generous. B-17 Flying Fortress. Oh no, Flight Sims. We're skipping that. Let's see what it looks like. Oh Jesus, it looks like...
That looks terrible.
Oh Jesus. Right,
that doesn't even look like something I'd want to play.
B-17 Bomber! Would be better than this shit.
That doesn't even look like... That doesn't even
oh,
look
hey,
like
you thought that flight sim game looked shit.
Now get the B-17 oh, wow. bomber back. No, this looks even worse.
Oh my god.
B-17 bomber.
There we go. We had to be just long enough for that. Bat. Please let this be less garbage than that shit. Okay, I think this image is supposed to be the bomb site that you are looking down, and I think the white things are clouds. I have no idea what the black things are. I think they might
Those
be like flash smoke puffs. I think they might be like flax smoke puffs or something. They're... From the, you know, the AA guns.
Oh.
I'm guessing that's what it is, because I can't imagine what the fuck else that could be. So yeah, that's that game. So now we have Bat.
Does Bat?
It's a cyberpunk romp through the underworld of crime and corruption. Whereas an agent for Bat, an ultra-secret organization serving the Confederation of Galaxies in the 22nd century.
It's also an adventure game.
I mean, it looks like it's a tolerable adventure game.
Yeah.
Made by Ubisoft.
So it can't be too bad. Yeah, it's a point-and-click adventure game, which is... So I will put those
that
on...
One, that
I'm
one
going to put both
like
of those
a rocket-powered
on the
horse.
I like how there's the Cow Koshin Conspiracy and Koshin Conspiracy CD version.
Oh.
I'm going to just put... Those seem
I'm
like they would be
the
interesting,
CD
so I'm just going to put
them on
the
voice
list.
Acting, so...
So, Bat. And B.A.T.
Oh, I just...
So I'm putting them onto the list of adventure games to come back, and we'll take a real quick look and see what they're like.
See, we finally made it out of A.
Yeah, we're finally out of A, and we're not getting any better in Crash, though.
Oh, that's some good Sega Genesis sound card.
Huh?
Oh, roll your character! I'm sure we go for full charisma.
I'm trying to figure out how. Oh, I see.
I'm sure you know what all of these stand for.
Well, these are basically your skills.
Mm-hmm.
These are your stats.
I've played an RPG or two.
And then there's a bunch of guns that we can take or not take. One of which looks basically like what I assume is a...
They all look like Men in Black guns.
We have guns. We have another gun. We have whatever the fuck this sort of gun is.
That's literally...
We have another whatever the fuck sort of gun this is.
That one thing was literally the mine wipe thing from Men in
Black. We can apparently take two guns. Or two weapons. So I guess we'll start with these things.
Take them all.
Okay, this is... No, because we can... Okay, so this is... Okay, our agent name is Fuckhead. We will save this agent. Okay.
Don't forget.
Now I just have to figure out how to points. Start.
You didn't adjust any points.
I'm not going to adjust any of the points. I'm not going to bother with fucking the things.
Oh.
I just want to figure out how to make it go. Okay, left click makes it go. That's useful. Definitely going to be a game we need a guide for because this looks very...
What's the robot saying? Would you mind not wasting my time? Talk to this Jawa. Don't think you speak his language either.
I'm trying to figure out how to go somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
What
are you buying? Well, this is a...
We have a thing implanted in our arm, apparently.
That's like the... Or, you know, that's like pre-Pip-Boy. You thought you could... Wrong.
Okay, now how do I get out of
you
this?
You actually have a card. One. Three.
There we go.
What's this? Really sweet kitty.
Okay, here's a restroom, apparently.
Although they are...
I'm literally just trying to figure out where I have to go.
Can you talk to Mr. Gardman there?
I'm trying.
Hmm? You've talked to everyone else but him. Hello?
Yeah, none of those restrooms look particularly sanitary.
Oh, Judge. Okay, everyone, I hate everyone here. Everyone's incredibly rude here.
I'm just trying to figure out where else, if anything, we could go. I don't see any way to go here.
What's in that question mark when you hover over that
can't
door in the
do
back?
Anything
is
there.
That the restroom?
Oh, Jesus. Oh. This is like stats of hydration and calories and shit.
Oh.
Oh, Jesus. This is going... We need a walkthrough to know how the fuck to play this shit.
How big is the instruction manual for this game, I wonder?
I have no idea.
Probably insane.
the instruction manual for this, which is apparently actually available for this one. Is 34 pages. Or that's twice that, actually.
Pretty,
well, twice that because it's basically they scanned each page one at a time.
That's still pretty big.
Well, let's see. I'm scrolling through to see the first 13 pages of it. So essentially that means that there would be, that's 34 PDF pages. So that means that there's probably like twice that, so it'd be 67 because the cover isn't duplicated. Isn't two pages. So the first 13 pages of it are actually basically things like story and stuff. Yeah. So there's a whole bunch of pages that are
really
just the story.
Really want you to get invested playing this game?
Which I don't care about at the moment. Then there's a glossary for a bunch of additional pages.
Yeah.
Okay, so it isn't until after page 21 that you actually get to controls.
How do we not die?
Okay. They're explaining characters, creating a character. There's apparently character level. So you need to eat and you need to drink. You have money you can get.
CJ, you gotta eat to keep your strength up.
Then there's like competencies that you can modify if you want to modify them. Then you have aptitudes based on your stats, which is simple enough. You have a bunch of guns.
Guns.
Okay. I is that there's nothing to do. So that's the regular icon. Then you have directions to indicate where you can move. Question mark tells you that you need something in order to accomplish something there.
Oh.
So my guess is that I needed to like do something in the call or something or other, but I don't give a shit yet. I mean, it seems playable if we have a guide. Then we have the next game, which is presumably going to be a similar design.
But what does BAT stand for?
I don't care. Oh, Jesus, this sure looks like a game. B-I-G. Oh, this looks quality. Looks super quality.
Comes on CD.
And extracts to 47 million WAV files and other files. And then also extracts the CD image, apparently. Free mind.
But what does big stand for?
I don't know.
This looks like somehow like.
Okay, I'm assuming this is new game. Novice, I assume. Oh no.
Oh, okay.
Well, this is a game. This looks like.
There must be a jump button, like, I would assume.
This looks like somehow more different flashback.
Yeah, I was reading the description in the bottom, and that's what it said. It was adventure game style reminiscent of Flash.
I like the music.
Well,
okay, I found out how to sort of jump.
That's a jump. There's another game where you can jump like that. It's really cool. I think that's gonna start shooting. Oh wow! So they just to get that screen cap, they literally just went down one screen.
Do I get like a weapon or something?
Yeah. Looks like it.
I don't know how to use it though.
Press I for.
Why is there a thing floating above my head now?
I don't. Oh.
Well, you can only see it when I crouch.
You've got a passport.
It's a radio. Somebody's
probably
trying
means,
to call
yeah.
you.
I bet that. Yeah, I bet that means you. Someone's trying to tell you about a mission objective.
Well, that would be great if I knew how the fuck to answer it.
Can you interact with these number?
Probably. Let's see. Is the manual available for this? Yes. Let's see. Does this have? Is this readable? Answer:
probably.
No. I cannot read the manual.
It's not in English.
No, it's not in English at all.
Wow.
I hope it might list the controls, though.
But somehow the title is in English.
Okay, I figured out. Okay, I found it. So it's number keys, switch, weapon.
So you have your magical katana.
It's the bike.
Like the die katana. Probably gonna die soon. It's a glove. This looks like a science center, but there's also a lot of loss of the big thing. But...
I think we've seen enough of this track.
You have 64
see,
of something.
The controls are also super awkward, apparently.
Can you climb down that ladder? I want to see if people start shooting.
I don't care. They probably will.
Okay, fine. Oh, wait. Jeez, this is just this is just a Jaguar game thing. This is on something else.
It's like if I could at least understand what the controls and what and the manual better, so I could actually know what the buttons are actually doing. I might be. I could. I could
other,
probably
this
do
is
it.
On some other system. Someone has streamed this before. Yeah, it's a 32X game. Zeta streamed it. Thought this. Yeah, Zeta streamed this when he was still doing 32X games.
No, I didn't know he was doing those before.
Well, not anymore. He did them all because there's so few of them.
Oh, I see.
Throw them in with Genesis because the emulator would do it as well, but there were so few of them that's already done them all. Yep, this sure looks like Flintstones racing. Aha, the dinosaur didn't go because dinosaurs are stupid.
Okay.
And they're going through their wet paint sign, so the Looney Tunes gag. Also, I liked how at the start there they started the gun off with
how
a stone gun.
Why do they even have guns in prehistoric time?
I have no idea
how to
control this.
We'll do it easier.
The suspension of disbelief for vehicles that could possibly be controlled with your bicycle, but.
Damn it, we're in the state of no idea what the controls are. There we are. No, bam, there we are. Done. Okay, I figured out how to go forward. Now I figured out how to turn.
It's a living!
I figured out how to pause.
That's important.
You'd think that turning would be the arrow key navigate through things, but no. Come on, game. What are the any of the buttons?
Is it the numpad?
No.
Is it just WASD?
No. It's Q to accelerate. Oh my god,
well,
what? They're going to look it up.
Is it JKL?
Okay, well, what's
also, that's also running into that is killing you, by the way.
What's the button you were using to go
Q.
forward? Q.
Yep.
Oh, look, it has a damage mechanic. That's interesting.
Which is not
that's not good in a game like this.
No. Okay, now what are the controls?
You know how in Mario Kart where you can just ring out because your cart gets damaged too much? No? Okay.
I said interesting, not good.
Oh, I know what you meant.
Okay, I figured it out, I think.
I was just elaborating.
So the controls to turn are comma and period.
Wow. Okay.
At least they're right next to each other. But still, you know, why not like WASD or like any other game?
I feel like there's a standard PC control scheme, right?
There's these incredibly useful buttons called the arrow keys, which it already demonstrated that it can use because it used them for selection in the main menu.
What are you using to attack?
I'm not even attacking. I'm just driving.
I think that may be automatically.
If
you get too close to a person, but you weren't there, so.
I mean, we had a thing. We raced.
Sure
we're done.
Not last.
That was trash.
Sure as Mario Kart without power-ups.
What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this?
It's a beast. I've seen this game before.
Holy shit, they actually made a BC game?
Oh my god, now how do we play this?
They made a video game on the BC comic. Oh, God.
Okay, player one, your turn. Now, how do I make it go?
You know, I like Wizard of Oz better.
Oh, we have the thing where I have to look up the controls again.
Oh.
Let's see. I can see that. So I think it is actually using the joystick. Yep. It sure is riveting.
That sure is a jump animation.
This
just kind of.
You have to duck under?
Yeah.
Hovering in the air for 2 seconds.
Oh man, I got hit by the thing. Oh, that sure is a game. We've seen all we need to of that. Ball! Okay, we at least have an action game this time, so it isn't complete trash. And we will also almost certainly be doing a real short pass on the backgammon game.
Ball.
Oh, another signal.
I guess they were big back then.
Well, they were big. They've had an awful lot of odd. Nice there, ball. At least you don't have ammo for the gun.
I guess that's a positive. Oh, that's dead. I see. That is a deadly thing.
Oh.
That's generally good to know.
I assume you can jump over it somehow.
is there jumping?
Wait, what is shooting at you?
A thing. I don't know how to make it stop.
Oh, that thing actually was a monster.
The problem is that there's no way to jump. All the buttons on the joystick are shoot. There is no jump.
Why is this first monster like hitting your ass?
If I'm hitting.
Oh, it's fall damage. Oh.
Oh my god, the controls are really bad because if you try, the only way to jump, from what I can tell, is to be hitting up on the controller and then hitting B.
Oh. Wow,
oh, that's a
mine.
Oh, this game sure is controllable.
This wants to be Duke Nukem so badly.
It's way worse than Duke Nukem.
What Duke Nukem?
Okay, we're done
like
with
this
trash. Okay, Baby Joe and Going Home.
That sounds like a blues album.
Sure. I mean, it's not going to be Biomiracle Oompa. But...
Oh.
Play it in German.
What are we doing?
Oh, no. I like the duck.
I do not like that face in the top. That is very off looking.
I think there's a lot of off stuff in this game.
Staring into your soul. That's Pac-Man cherries.
The jumps are really annoyingly hard.
Ice cream!
Trying to jump is really a pain in the ass.
Oh. Fire bad! Oh.
Because it's literally pressing up on the joystick on my Xbox controller, which of course is super easy to do.
Yeah, like a fighting game. Oh. At least he doesn't have a crying sound like Mario.
There is music, by the way.
I'm listening to the music. I'm hearing it. But at least he didn't have a crying sound effect from what.
There is also apparently... Oh, no, I think I got hit by the... I was thinking there was fall damage really short distances, and I realized I was just hit by the beat.
Don't get that present over the fire. That's a red herring. So what are with games and making you play as baby? Babies do so much, you know, just like in real life.
Okay, we're done with this trash.
Good.
Back to Baghdad. Oh no, flight simulator, skipping that. Oh boy, Back to the Future 2.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, they have both parts for you. This is the Mega Drive version.
Oh Jesus. Okay.
Maybe it'll be better than the Mega Drive version.
MCGA VGA. We
you
want.
You don't want
C for add to the music. And we want keyboard.
Marty. Great Scott!
Hashtag one. By the way, to warn everyone, hashtag messages is particularly hashtag memes will be deleted.
Thank you. Economy helps improve our.
The music is honestly not actually that bad.
Well, if there's one thing these games get, these
fire,
license games usually get the
pause,
use the
abort.
Yeah, they usually get the title song correct, and then they never stop playing it. Like the Simpsons game.
Okay, whatever.
At least he didn't put the NES first game in.
Oh, hello, Fal.
Marty! It's time to come back!
Oh, holy shit. What are the controls here? What am I controlling?
Hey, Fal, how are you?
Let's try this again. I swear I redefined the controls, but maybe it didn't.
You're being attacked by a future Tricer.
Let's try this again. I think that it may have not actually registered the control changes. Okay. Redefine keys. Up, down, left, right, fire, pause, and backspace. Okay, let's try this again.
You know what I haven't seen?
The controls don't seem to be moving. I don't seem to be able to move.
I need a game based on the Back to the Future.
Maybe you have to press A to move?
No, just defined the key. And he's like, he reacts to the fire button. I can abort the game, so it registered those. Okay, let's try doing a different set of keys. We'll do I, K, J, L.
So we need a game based on the Back to the Future animated cartoon.
Let's try these keys. Maybe it just doesn't like the arrow keys. Okay, there we go. It just doesn't like the arrow keys. Fair enough. I mean,
I like the arrow keys. Why can't you like them, game?
At least now I understand how to control this. Oh man, it
is
so
this is
so
one
bad.
Of those games where everything is trying to kill you for no reason.
Of course.
You missed the rebound.
So you start out by playing Paperboy.
Okay, so to go forward, you actually have to hit down repeatedly to kick, essentially.
That's kind of neat.
It makes sense, sort of, but it takes a while to actually
figure
out where.
You got to have power!
Literally a thing every single square on the screen.
Oh, wow.
Future Cat. Oh, get some Pepsi. I'm sure that's a health.
It's Future Pepsi.
Yeah.
Then you just get to ride.
In the far-off future of 2015.
I can only imagine trying to do the cool thing to the game, only
the trash cans try to kill you.
There's Doc Brown, I think.
I think that was Old Man Biff.
Was it? I couldn't.
Running Ashby. Oh yeah, there's Doc with the shades. I think the guy with the cane was Old Man Biff.
Stuck on the wall. There we go.
There are random bumps.
They look like Future Biff.
I have no idea where I'm going or why.
Oh, it's auto scroll. There we go. Jaws 19.
Okay, we actually died there. I think we've seen enough of this trash. Moving on.
System Mega Drive version.
Oh man, Biff killed you.
Oh no. That sure is.
Oh hey, this is the Genesis version.
Oh, that face.
The one that's just
on the preview screenshot there.
Oh,
the
God,
one that's just a series of terrible mini-games.
Ooh! These sounds you kind of need to hear. Ooh.
Ugh. remember, the first one is Doc riding a horse and getting hit by everything.
Oh, hey, here we have the faces!
Doc, what's happened to our faces?
It's the horse. Pretty much if you get hit by anything, you're already lost. Maybe it's
I think we already know this game. We've seen this shit. That's more than enough of that.
Yeah.
We have now 5 different backgammon games.
I'm fine with you skipping all of them.
Yeah, let's skip all of them.
Huh.
Oh, those are bad.
I mean, it's backgammon.
Yeah, we know how backgammon works. We don't.
It's not even backgammon with neat graphics. It's like, CGA backgammon. Check it out, cyan.
Okay, Backlash, a turret gunner simulation.
Lash back.
Sure, we won't distribute this shit. Whatever.
Don't copy that floppy.
Okay, difficulty. Easy. Help.
Oh boy. Don't want to go on a rampage.
Anyway.
Hey.
Okay, let's go with new Operation Backslash. Okay, we have mission 1. F5 is targeting.
What? Function key? No. Game? No. Why?
Eh. Okay, we see how it works. Equipment, we have missile rack. Apparently, we have 8 of them. Dumbfire, heavy damage, 8 reloads. And we have no money, so that's all we can get. So, let's go.
Time to backlash!
I'm not hearing any sound. Thanks. Maybe the sound doesn't work.
Sure is a cool black screen.
Game? Well, that doesn't seem to work. I will put that on the list of games to come back to if we can figure out how to work.
Good game. Back. Oh, I think Belt needs to 100% this.
Educational.
Let's let some anthropomorphic mice teach us things.
Includes the playroom and the treehouse.
Edutainment.
Oh boy.
Sound works.
Hi, I'm Peppermouse.
Oh no.
This is
talking.
A preview of the playroom
of
where you can learn
talking.
Beginning reading, counting, and telling time. 3. E-L.
Oh, the dragon. Why is it a preview, though? How do we...
I don't get it. Hold on, let me make sure it's the right size.
There we
go. Go back. One.
What?
Make crazy.
Okay, I just came back, and this looks like something for babies.
How do we get back out? Okay, now.
Hi, hey. I'm Peppermouse. This is a preview of the playroom.
That's great.
So
that's
how do
great.
I actually go to the playroom?
Hi, I'm Peppermouse.
I think that is the playroom.
Well, it says it's a preview of the playroom.
Maybe this is the shareware version?
Maybe.
The backyard is the place to be.
Oh.
We'll be hard pressed to...
What is this?
The backyard
you weren't
is
actually
the place
in the
be.
Game itself. You were in this thing that switches
There's
between
to
game
do
and its add-on.
To see. The backyard is the place to be.
Oh, no. It's got a song.
There's lots
with lyrics.
To do and lots to see. The backyard is...
No,
hi,
artists,
I'm Ginger.
In quotes.
Hello, I'm Pepper. Moves.
Okay.
So this is basically one of those click on random shit and random
really
shit
scared.
Happens games, huh?
Disgusting.
What are emotions?
Furious.
Oh, no.
Wow, surprise.
The mouse control's really fucked up, too.
Very happy.
Oh, the nightmare faces.
Arr, matey.
Oh, you can
so
click
can you
on
move stuff
it?
On the face?
You can click on it to change what it is. Oh, okay, we're done with that.
Oh, God.
Ah, come on, move.
Getting a little too creative. Go on the bird.
Oh, we can paint the fence. The mouse control is so bad. Oh, I see. By painting the fence different colors, you control which note is the bird plays on the fence.
Oh, it's a xylophone bird.
God, the mouse is so fucked up in this game. It's like it's got some sort of weird pseudo-acceleration shit.
Now you know how I was playing, felt when I was playing Woodruff and the Schnipple.
Wow, this is That's sure a hard game of tic-tac-toe.
You're playing with an alien, Belle. An alien! Look at it.
Huh? Let's go hard, whatever the fuck it is.
Harder map.
Okay. What are we doing?
Is this one of these follow the program?
Oh no, that's way too hard.
Yeah, let's just get to the end.
I guess.
Avoid all the things.
I guess.
It's a challenge, because it doesn't actually show your thing on the map.
We found a lined-up rower. Hooray.
Oh, are there collectibles in this game?
Is that what happened to the playroom? They all go in there. They all go in the cornfields.
That's only what you think. That's only when you think big bad thoughts about the playroom.
Oh, we got a wind-up monkey. Hooray!
You should call your dad and tell him. Tell dad, I got the wind-up monkey. Good job.
Can you print off a certificate saying that you found the wind-up monkey?
Apparently not. Oh, hey, we can do the same face again.
9 out of 10. Close.
But this time,
oh, no, we can just, we're just able to put random things on the
do
pumpkin.
Do you want to put everything away?
No.
Like worms.
Oh, holy shit, when I click on this thing, you gotta hear the voice sound for this.
Do you want to put everything away? No.
No. Ready.
No.
How does this even work? Just sticking, you're setting vegetables on a pumpkin and they magically stick to
it. That's literally it. And we can put...
What are you posting?
Do something with this. Oh, I see. You can eat things by to take them away.
Ow.
Do you want to print this? No.
No, I don't want to print this horrifying abomination of garbage.
Thank you.
Kit Fox. Horned Toad.
Okay.
Well, that doesn't look like a fun time.
Assemble the fox. Oh, it's going to confuse you. Getting multiple animal parts here.
See, now it's not a kit fox, it's a fox kit. Assemble your own.
God, the mouse.
Wasn't there
so
one of those
bad.
Final kit Destination fox. Movies where the escalator eats someone?
That was Final Destination 2.
Final Destination, where everything can kill you because, well, we thought
because
it
could. Screw you. That's why. That's pretty Horned much those
Toad.
Movies, right? Like, oh, you don't want to die? Tough.
Oh, you didn't want to die in a plane crash. Well, fine. Now you get to die because everything breaks Ooh. Around you.
Oh, wait.
Tropical rainforest, you can bet. It's always hot and very wet.
Oh boy, and more rats.
You know, it's all ice and snow.
Remember that one penguin movie they kept calling Zula's wrong name?
Ocelot.
Zeta would remember.
Spider monkey.
More like Happy Feet.
It was
Arrow
a
poison
Happy
frog.
Feet knockoff.
Oh.
Skua.
Like Tappy toes.
Leopard seal.
I wouldn't be
Crab
surprised if that was the
seal.
Actual name of
Myself.
It.
Myself.
It was...
More raps will be coming.
It was
in
a
the desert,
penguin movie
so
told, where the penguin...
Days are hot, nights are cold.
Can't tell if it was trying to be Happy Feet or... Because it looked like it was made before Happy Feet.
Well, you can always make the rip-off movies before. Just go by the trailer or the poster. and make up the entire plot.
Well, here, hammer.
Can't be worse than what they actually wind up with.
Let me look at whether what's made.
And sometimes they're just movies that have absolutely nothing to do with the movie they're allegedly ripping off. They're marketed as a ripoff.
What the fuck is going on?
Like that one movie that had nothing to do with Frozen at all, but then when they
play with Bongobot
released it in supermarkets, they decided, let's make the cover look a lot like Frozen.
Beginner head.
Let's try the Bongobot beginner head.
Easier game.
Okay.
Head for Bongobot.
Harder game.
What the fuck are we doing?
My turn.
Roadrunner.
Let's see. The Adventures of Scamper the Penguin. Copyright 2004. Happy Feet was copyright 2000.
Okay, I guess we need to go for...
Click here, or here.
Okay.
Two. One. Two.
Ooh, what the fuck?
Oh!
What are we doing?
Assembling birds?
I don't know what we're doing.
It's like a...
I think we're trying to assemble them, yeah.
Got like a Roadrunner and a toucan.
One. One. Go anywhere.
Okay, so the stars let you go anywhere, I see.
My turn.
Roadrunner.
Guess you just gotta assemble the whole scene.
Apparently.
One. One.
Oh!
I have no idea what the fuck I'm doing. I can't.
You could probably move backwards too.
Toucan.
That's true.
That's not a Roadrunner speed. That's like pigeon.
One.
There's like a quail there as well.
One.
Okay, I see. So you do. So I am. You have to land on the place that is part of it. I understand.
Roadrunner. Roadrunner.
Hello.
Hey.
Hey. Hi.
What is up? Okay, it looks like though you've got the.
One. Go anywhere.
Okay, so now we get to go anywhere. So let's go.
Let's get the Roadrunner's body.
Well, no, because I want to go back to the earliest one, because that way I can move forward for the rest.
Hooray!
How do you do, fellow kids?
We're playing this game.
Putting a Roadrunner together.
Or two can.
Two. One.
So whatever you have in the background,
two.
It's coming through really loud.
Yeah, that's pretty loud.
I don't know. I've been going.
It sounds like the PS4 music.
Okay.
Three. One. Two. Three. Go anywhere.
Now we're going anywhere. So we go back for these.
Hooray!
Two. One. Two.
It's So the quail is still there to use you.
Mm-hmm.
And the snake, if you're angry.
My turn.
Glad they managed to make, you know.
Hey, back.
You know, three-sided, two. Six-sided die here.
Well, that's perfectly feasible. One. This happens like two, three twice.
Go anywhere.
Yep.
And hello again.
It's like the problem this game has is that there's like all these go anywhere squares.
Okay, I'll just use my phone instead.
Well, the game is made for like
true.
3-year-olds, so.
One.
It should one. Also appeal to 30-year-olds.
I think the robot's gonna beat you.
Probably.
Oh no. You cheated!
I totally care.
You should care.
Yeah, I care so much.
You still gotta put the lizard head on your Roadrunner tail to make it a basilisk.
Ooh, I forgot. It's a new month for PlayStation Plus. I wonder what's free.
Crab eater seal.
Let's go back and see if there's anything else.
Oh, no. It's different. I like birds better.
Let's see. Free for PlayStation Plus. Beyond Two Souls and Rayman Legends.
Okay, I think we've seen all of this that I care to see.
Yeah, it's pretty good, Purple, but it's kind of annoying because I just bought it for Switch a few months ago.
Hi, this is a preview of the treehouse. Up in the treehouse...
I see, so the treehouse and the playroom, etc. are just other games that we will probably wind up doing at some point.
Yeah.
Okay, Bad Blood.
The images are working fine for me, Mag.
What is this? Post-apocalyptic.
Looks like it's supposed to be some sort of twin-stick shooter with a terrible UI.
Hey,
oh, actually,
bad
it looks
dudes.
Like it might be.
Bad this dudes will is be, next.
This will be the definitive version of it. Weirdly,
mm-hmm. Bad
it might
blood
be like an RPG.
You gotta have bad blood to be bad dudes.
Oh, it's
gotta nice. Save President Ronnie. Remember when you could have a game where you saved the president and people wouldn't be all upset about that?
What?
I'm sure some people were back then. They
yeah,
just didn't
probably.
Have an internet to bitch on.
Yeah, you're probably right.
I know Beyond Two Souls is like Heavy Rain or something, which I honestly
yeah,
sure was
Heavy
Rain.
Yeah, it's like Heavy Rain with like time travel and like a ghost.
David Cage doing his David Cage thing. 36 gigabytes!
Yeah?
I don't have the space for that.
Then PlayStation can pick up a lot of space.
You'll need to have more space, then.
I know, I need to get a bigger hard drive for my PS4. Then, I guess, take the hard drive I'm using and then plug it into my computer, and I have more space for that, too.
We got big trubs. Big trubs.
That was totally a story here.
Yeah, we've got dudes fighting. And they're talking about the humans doing things. And he's talking about, we're going to get hammered.
The humans!
We can't just turkle Man. Up and hope the humes buzzer off. Sure.
Oh, he's a guy.
Blue. Rayman Legends.
Are we playing Final Fantasy XI now?
Blue Fishman?
What? If no one pilfs her patch, what the fuck are you on about?
Which of
That's
these charred corpses do you want to play as?
I said fairy, the strongest tough. I seen him slag a whole band. What the fuck is this?
Oh yeah, man, I want to pitch her patch.
Just be the big guy. Like post-future Norman.
She's a shivy slicer.
So they were like trying to be a little bit Mad Max, I guess.
Okay, so apparently, oh, I see. They talk about her eye patch because apparently she has Cyclops laser vision in that eye, or something.
Ew. Ew.
Cool.
Unless it's Kano.
You should play the Cyclops lady then.
I think that is this. Okay, so this is the big guy. This is the Cyclops lady, and this is the cube. Okay, so which tough do we send?
Well,
let's go with Cyclops lady. Okay. A laser eye.
I'm thinking tough we send. I'm thinking great Hulk demon.
So we need to go and find what the humans are all upset about and make them and convince them not to come over and attack the whatever.
Stop them with so smart.
Be the smarts.
Yes, I have banned everything related to Dan Buru everywhere in this. You will not be able to link it. No matter what you do, Kupo, you cannot link Dan Buru in any
no
way.
No prawns.
You will also, nobody other than you can see it either, by the way. So I extra did it. Okay, so it's a top-down adventure game, I think.
Oh.
Okay, that picks up some grenades.
Two terabyte external hard drive, $65.
That's not bad.
These sure are some walking animations.
Good lord, I was curious to see 6 terabytes, but it's like a giant thing. Mm.
Yeah, that's...
These
are all the people you were just talking.
4 terabytes for 100. I'm like in dire need of space right now.
We should go and find the Oracle somewhere and do that and talk to them. We'll probably not be playing this that long.
I need to talk to an Oracle to determine what hard drive to get?
Yes.
That's definitely what we're talking about. I think you're wandering out in the desert.
Yeah, I figured that.
Look, it's a rad ant?
Oh, I don't rad know spider. What it is.
Frostbite spider? Desert.
We got bug spray now.
I'm sure that'll be real effective. Maybe it will, I don't know. I'm not from the future, so...
Okay, so hitting space literally fires a laser blast, so that is literally what they meant.
So it has like a real-time attack. At least you can't kill NPCs.
Looks like it, or it may not even have hit him because I don't know where the collision box is. Okay, there's a second floor to this one.
Gank all this stuff. Oh, you got some nades.
We have a lot of grenades. No, I don't want to shoot them. I want to go in the door.
You want to use all grenades at once?
Oh, I got a bow. There was a bow in our house, apparently, which I didn't even realize was a bow.
Oh.
Oh, come on, don't... And apparently the NPCs can walk into you in such a way that you cannot actually move. Okay, let's go out into the desert for a bit and see what it's like. It is noon, by the way.
I imagine it's very hot.
We got food from killing the rad ant thing. Oh, that's an enemy.
Coyote?
Okay, that bar on the that bottle on the right is not just decoration, that's your health meter.
Oh. Oh, hurt you, boy. See, I is your inventory. Something hurt you.
You
are also carrying 11 portions of food.
Oh, we died. Okay, we're done. That is sure. We've seen worse, sadly.
Bad blood sure is bad.
It looked playable if you really want.
Yeah, it's better than a lot of these trash garbage. Which is even fucking playable. You get past the
first level of DOS bad dudes.
And sure it is.
Actually, I didn't even know there was a DOS version. I probably would have liked
to play that. Get into Discord, WeA. You should be part of this trash.
This trash garbage. This is just calling it trash isn't enough.
Also, just a...
Found jump.
Oh boy, bad dudes.
Oh no.
Couldn't even have some boop dip.
There is some boop dips, but I figured out the controls, and oh man, this game is shit. I do love his strut,
though. To move left, you press control.
No, to move left, you press 9, 7, and then you just keep going left until you hit the other direction.
You get the card off?
We just saw the strut. As exactly how I walked places.
Loading Karnov. There he is. Oh. Karnov, you're not looking.
Okay, we're done with that trash.
Happy slaps. Oh, fuck off, Uplay. Leave me alone. I'm on console.
Why would that matter?
Oh, bet. Really? This had a DOS version, too?
Yeah.
Hot Pants Fighter? Or Short Shorts Fighter? Whatever.
Really fucked up screen resolution. Okay.
Play as a granny, too?
Oh, the music. I just need to figure out what the attack button is.
Old man approaching. Beating up the old.
This looks like a really heavily upscaled Game Boy here.
What the fuck is the attack button, game?
How do you brawl? This isn't bad screen roller, it's bop and run rumble according to this.
I literally cannot find a single attack button. Like in so many of these games, I literally cannot find a button that is attack.
Is it roll? Tab?
Look it up.
You figured it out.
Okay, I figured out how to do it. Okay. Oh man, the controls are fucked up.
Slash. Backslash.
Okay, the way you fight is you have to hit... is you have to hold enter and then hit a direction.
Oh, what?
And that controls which attack you do, and one of the attacks is apparently a ball bomb.
It's the best attack.
Ooh. I like feeling your enemy up.
Always go for the ball bomb, those last thing they expect.
Also, since you're just fighting old men so far.
Okay, we've got another thing that is a thing.
Oh, huh, they ported Super Star Wars to the PS4. I didn't know. There's a Star Wars sale going on. May the Force be with you. Ha 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 ha.
Can you defeat Lava Beast Jawenko? It's like Jawa, but.
You have two enemies who basically are on two sides of your base. Okay, we have seen all we're gonna see of that shit. Bad, bad.
Beating
sure
up the elderly,
is.
The game. Yep, it looks exactly like the title. Oh, is this freeware? Really? I couldn't tell. Oh, it's an adventure game.
Ooh, it's a sexually oriented game with... What? What? What?
Your girlfriend is only 15. Nope.
No! No! No!
But it's extremely mature and extremely horny.
No! Fuck off!
Huh?
Oh, we have more text
I've seen this anime.
What?
Balance! Okay, at least it's a game.
Yeah, it could have been a lot worse. Yeah, you are 22. Your girlfriend is currently 5.
Your girlfriend is a very mature 11.
Oh, Jesus. Don't give
very
these
mature.
People ideas. Oh, no. It's in German.
What?
Oh god. Playing this new twin stick shooter that came out, and one of the weapons that you have is a rubber fowl. Like F-O-W-L. And it makes the scream whenever you swing it at somebody.
What game is this?
Game is this? Juicy Realm.
Juicy Realm?
Ah!
You didn't balance.
Okay, that is sure unplayable trash. Oh, Jesus.
When you get back to the games, can you check if you have a game on your list for me?
What is it?
Morath's Dungeon of the Unforgiven.
Where is M? M? I assume it's M-O.
Yeah.
And
the Habmo game.
Morass. I have a whole bunch of Morass games. I have a whole
yes,
bunch of.
Yes, Gavin! This game.
Oh
good.
Boy, Mortal Kombat.
That game's terrible, Bell. You'll love it.
Oh, boy. Balance of Power, which basically
numbers
looks like
game,
shitty
the
Risk.
Game.
We're not doing either of those trash things.
Balance of the Planet!
What the fuck is this? Why is there a random baby?
Oh, hey, you have Baldies. That's
because it's Metroid Other M. I don't know.
Baldi's is like a puzzle game.
Is it tolerable?
It's supposed to be, although the mechanics are kind of weird.
What is this?
Are you God? It's like Simmer. Sim Life.
How do I get out of this?
Oh, neat. Star Ocean 4 is on sale on PlayStation Network.
How do I get out of things, game?
Why does God need a budget?
I don't know. This is unplayable trash.
I don't. I've...
Whatever the fuck that crap is unplayable trash. What?
That's true about every game.
Far too many of them, yes. Why
not
do you think
every game
be
in general
doing...
is unplayable trash?
It's like some sort of it's like a puzzle RTS. Sense, yeah.
Please let it actually be some sort of thing which is actually a fucking game as opposed to whatever the crap we've been encountering usually.
You have to build up your Baldies and then take over all the non-Baldies. Also, are you okay, Fowler? You're kind of breathing heavily.
My allergies have been killing me lately.
Hope you feel better.
Well, if they're killing you, how are you still alive?
I think you can have Baldies build more houses, then have them start...
I'm trying to figure out how to make things get built.
Quiet! Stop it. What's wrong with you?
Yeah, you need a barrack. I just don't vaguely how what you need.
You need to go outside? Yes?
Like, you can get them to build stuff and research weapons.
I get
and...
that. I'm trying to figure out how.
Yeah.
The problem is trying to figure out how to make any instructions be a thing. How do game? How do I do anything in this thing?
First time sex in a nutshell.
This is... I think that this is an unplayable piece of uncommunicative mess.
It is playable, but...
No, I wouldn't say it's playable.
I'd have to look up the controls for you.
It's way more than just the missing controls. It's missing literally any explanation for how you do things.
Well, I don't think it actually tells you. Maybe I'll look it up and try and play it sometime.
Okay. Oh, hey, I think the food is here.
From what I saw, it's not terrible, but it's different. You're right.
Okay, I'm back.
That was quick.
Yes, it has a manual, but
did you eat all? You ate all the food already?
Of time into these things, and these games are likely worth. Okay. Let's see. Ball Blazing Fantasy.
Bill, you ate all the food that fast?
Yep, definitely.
Just consume.
don't get sound for this one. Okay, so we got... Okay.
I think about maybe getting an SSD for my computer and reload Windows onto that.
Using the arrow keys like you would expect.
Okay, I'm back. Was ball blazing? Time to blaze some balls.
I'm reading how you're supposed to play this. Okay. So you want to collect all the minerals and then, oh, we died. That's an enemy. We are literally made of an actual, like, rubber ball or whatever, so we bounce off of things. Ugh, the controls are really not very good. Collision physics is very difficult to actually manage. You also have a gigantic fucking hitbox.
You are bald. Try to survive.
Why do you have to collect minerals?
Well, because that's the quest mode.
Watch out for the grass bear.
The other mode is basically like a sports game sort of thing.
That doesn't sound fun.
That's why I'm doing the quest mode, which is at least seems to be a little more interesting. Okay, we're done.
I mean, at least it's not a RoboCod game.
The RoboCod games might be better. I think we've seen enough of this. We've seen a level, we've beaten a level, we're done.
GG. Oh, this is that game, the walk around. It's basically go.
Go. We just got here.
Othello,
I mean. Reminds me of Othello I knew once.
on to FA.
Cold months.
Let's just see a demo.
On something?
Yeah, help.
Although I'm not eating anything right at the moment.
Now somebody is.
Now I'm eating.
If you're a toad and therefore a mushroom, could you just eat yourself?
Dead bird will make your skin crawl. This eats me up. Presents. Gives terrible gifts. When it is near, temperature seems to go up about 20 degrees. I could use one right now as fuck. I'm not near.
That stuff Bill has to look forward to in Morath's dungeon at the given. You take over all the squares, Bill?
Unless it's an actual fun game.
But I'm not allowed to do that for Persona 4 Arena Ultimax.
That's an actual fun game. That's not this garbage track.
Yeah. That way for my streams, I can just set it to auto and just let the game go.
You also don't have 1,000 games to go through.
Yeah. And this is also
yeah, I'm just lazy. Gameplay though. That game story is so token muzzled with computer play. I'm playing Dead Rising for the first time, and goddamn, Frank West is a stick lodged so far up his ass. The way he moves, it's like he always has to poop.
He's ready to smack some zombies upside the head. What
Remember,
for?
He's covered wars before.
Yeah, that's true.
Covered him on what?
About that Humble Bundle that had a Humble Bundle for PlayStation that had a whole bunch of Capcom and Sega things. Had Dead Rising and Dead Rising 2 and Valkyria Chronicles for PS4.
I wonder, does Potato Peeler work with Bone Hearts? No, it does not.
And Alien Isolation, so I can see if I'm actually good at it.
Be sneaky. Be aggressive. Be both.
So sneaky and aggressive, so rapist?
What?
Sure. Rape the alien.
Well, Fowl said be sneaky and aggressive, so like what, like a rapist? like the alien? Usually they're that face dong is gonna do that to you.
Yeah,
that's really cool of it is that the Humble Bundle also gave me a bunch of discount codes for PlayStation Network for other things.
Okay, I think we're done.
Yeah, I'm not impressed by this game at all.
I suppose. Ball Race.
Ugh.
The keys. Okay, space.
At least some of these games actually think what the.
Are they better with Kinect?
Goddamn, 10 minutes into Dead Rising 1 and there's already a blonde girl with giant boobs.
Huh?
Of course.
You are the controller.
Like, do you have a zombie, you know, based game without it?
Fair enough.
I mean, my guess is that hopefully very few people bought this game so that he decided not to keep trying and working on this trash, but...
Ball Race. It's the exciting racing game that'll make you say balls.
And naturally, Frank is looking at her ass, and the camera focuses on it.
Gotta get that Pulitzer shot.
Yeah.
Okay, these are the ball racers. It's the enemy. Energy ball you hit. Mines you'd want to avoid. Torpedoes aren't there. You want to avoid grease slick. You want to get speed dust. Then there's Alice's mushroom. What the fuck? I've come to the keys.
All these features are not supported in this version?
Oh, I see. It's the numpad.
Okay, I tested it out. Turns out, when you have skull bone hearts, you can pick up Abaddon, but it empties all of them.
What about if you pick up Abadox? Remember, Bell, torpedoes are not active in this version.
Okay, how do we play this shit?
I don't know. Half the controls aren't playable in this version. Sound.
Oh, you like that sound, do you?
Yeah, that was fantastic.
I can't turn on the stream audio on my laptop, otherwise it'd be echoing into my phone. I'm sure the sound is pleasant.
It's beeping that.
Sound is great.
It's like the soothing foods of an electronic baby. It just shit itself.
I think we're done with this trash.
Doesn't that make you want to pay for the full version, Belt?
Only if it would allow me to go over to his house and punch him in the face.
Why do you want to do that?
Because I want to make him stop.
think you probably did.
Wait, is this just a...
Oh, this is great. It's like you gotta pick what your speed of your computer is.
Which speed is your computer at? Do you think you can...
I don't know. Let's try 2.
You think you can handle the 66 megahertz?
No, it's a pretty fast processor.
So this is going to go like a million miles an hour? Want to see shit? Put it away. Now! These are the... These are the voyages of the Purple Ball and its ongoing mission to explore the galaxy. Collect as many dilithium crystals formed by
Starfleet.
That was the story.
This is my original story.
Okay.
Welcome to Ball Game 2. The game of your dream.
How does this work?
You didn't want to hear any more of that wonderful text?
It's more playable than that other rubber ball game.
Collect the minerals, but they're dilithium crystals now. Oh, what happened? Why does the music just start?
Who the fuck knows?
Hello.
Oh, hey, it's Arklon joining us for the terrible trash.
We're gone. Bust your balls, Arklon.
Whoa. God bless all the balls.
Oh, Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, hey, this bomb. Oh, I fell off.
So they decided to do a not how to make a Marble Madness game?
Basically.
This is Marble Madness.
Not even that.
Marble shitness.
It's like, collect all the things and get the eggs.
We're done with this.
Oh, but it was just getting good.
Ball... Is it... Oh, ballistics.
So you would say this game sucks balls?
Yes.
I would definitely say that.
This looks like Future Pong.
I'm pretty sure you're right. Which is sad.
I see it was released on the Amiga.
Yep.
Fucking Amiga. Hey, he said the thing, he covered Wars.
What? I don't get it.
Plain Dead.
Dead Rising.
Oh.
The meme of Frank Weiss always saying he covered Wars.
Well, that sure is a piece of art drawn by somebody who doesn't know how to draw fucking art.
Well, this company's been around forever.
F1.
It's either pinball or pong.
Maybe it's a combination of both.
Okay, so up, down, left, right, fire. Okay.
Up.
Ugh, you press R2 and then square to fire? That's weird.
Okay, what is this shit? What am I controlling? Oh, I see.
I
just figured it out. It's really hard to do, but I get it.
I don't. Please explain.
You have to hit the... You have to shoot the thing to make it ballistically bounce around into the other goal.
Oh.
And it's really a giant pain in the ass, so we've seen all we're gonna see of that track.
So it's the video game version of,
It's slow software. Shitty puzzle game.
You caught up in there.
You caught up in the...
That was Crossfire!
What is this, Robotron? Robotron?
Well, this is slow software. All of his games are shit puzzle games. Press any key.
Which one is any key?
Red plays.
Which one's the any key?
I beat it away.
Okay.
Oh, quick, ask Pig up what to do.
Oh, God, what are we looking at?
I don't know.
Looks like a bunch of garbage.
I see airplanes.
Okay, the idea is you need to try and get the balloons to the top of the screen, I think. And the arrows indicate which way the thing will go when it hits that.
Oh, this is such a pretty game. So pleasing to the eyes, for it's honest.
See, and so that one, for example, failed because it hit a thing.
Come on, I need to find the silly outfits to put Frank West in.
Oh, you're going up against an opponent. Oh, what? Oh, okay. Whirlwinds are teleported.
Yeah. And if you'll notice, the arrow keys change direction as you go. I mean, it's a tolerable puzzle game. It's just also kind of shit.
Is it that tolerable, though?
Compared to some of the other shit that Solo Software has made, this is golden.
God damn, this lady's all here is attacking my crotch.
So, what you're saying, Beld, is if you set your sights low enough, anything is possible.
Yeah, pretty much.
I see you get less points if your his balloons are ahead of.
This seems like the kind of computer game we'd play back in the day when I was a kid at school.
You probably would have, yeah. That apparently got stuck there.
Back in my day, honey!
Pretty much. I'm getting
software is the best we got, and we liked it. Uphill, both ways.
Well, not that old.
I think we've seen enough of this shit.
Yep.
I never had to do
it's
that.
It's better than some of Solo's software garbage, but it's still shitty.
I did have to play games like this.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, I feel bad for you.
Balloon fight.
Oh, it is balloon fight.
Hey, balloon fight's all right.
Oh, well, I like the Nintendo game.
I wonder how they managed to fuck it up.
I'm sure they did.
It looks like balloon fight, but I get the feeling knockoff balloon fight.
Yeah. Oops, I started the wrong one.
Isn't that just joust?
Kind of like, hey, guys,
everyone shut up. We have to take a moment to ponder the benefits of registration.
Pondering.
Let me ponder that for a minute. I'm not doing it. Mostly because the system. Yep.
Oh god, we will rock. Steam.
Totally want to register knockoff balloon fight.
I gotta listen to this.
We will rock you, I see.
Just the beginning.
So just the beat, not anything else.
Yeah.
Do 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 do.
Come on, Bell, don't you wanna figure your puff gunners?
I gotta figure out how to.
At least they didn't use the onboard audio there for it. Just imagine that. That would have been great.
Computer speaker.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Speaker.
What the fuck is this?
Puff string.
It'd just be the sound of madness, wouldn't it, Fal?
I wish I could customize my puff string.
What?
Ooh. It literally is balloon fight, by the way.
Like, the sprite even looks exactly the same.
They lifted it off the game!
No, that's what I was saying.
Well, definitely want to register this, then. Pay for the full version.
Can you register this so we can pay our lawyers?
It has some great sound effects, though.
I mean, this looks like balloon fight, but... balloon fight wasn't like this, thank God. The mini game was like this. It's like they took the mini game and they made it into a full game.
Didn't see you making.
But yeah, you need to hear the sound that happens when I die.
Okay, I'll turn it on.
I don't think I ever played any version of Balloon Fight.
That sure is a sound effect.
They did all this, they added like goofy sound effects and the. Looking at 256 colors.
Are you like shooting at the balloons?
Yeah, I'm puffing at them.
Yeah.
They're supposed to be two players, though.
It's your puff gunner. How did he make the... They obviously had keyboard for the one sound. This would be more fun with two players.
Yeah. So one of you just needs to fly over here to San Francisco.
Parsec.
Only one of us is a bird, so.
Parsec.
That's too far.
you get in here and you'll see you flew over to San Francisco
and
wear your arms
tired.
Yep.
Oh, Beld, we could use Parsec.
That would be far too much effort for this crash.
That's too much. But then.
We've seen everything this game has to offer.
I would say so.
Well, Ballyhoo,
which is... They have a real interesting-looking thing on the back cover, but it's just a text adventure. Skipping that. Bananatron! Which is probably going to be not Tron.
Ring, 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 ring. Bananatron! it's light cycles. Check it out.
Yeah, what's the interruption? Huh? Oh, it's a game for multiple players.
Or single player.
Oh no, it's Light Cycles.
Yeah, I know. But would do you have to play with, does it put, did you have to have a second person, or would it, does it have
yes,
an AI?
Yes, you need two people. Great sound, too.
It's Snake.
Yep.
Snake?
Snake!
Saki.
That was the name of the game.
Oh, hey, I wonder what this game is.
That is clearly Pac-Man. I mean, come on.
Yeah, that's what I mean. What do you think of it?
Do, do, do. Do, do, do.
Banana now.
I think it's bananoid. Bananoid? Or is that a V? Banov.
Bananov.
Who knows?
Except it's Arkanoid. You fail!
You just disintegrate for failure.
That sounds right.
Yeah, it's also alleyway.
But you can shoot?
Well, it's a power-up.
Was it just me, or did that ball get glitched inside of one of them?
No, that it did indeed do. Oh, that was
brilliantly done.
I can't ball physics.
When I play the breakout game, I think I need to see have a cat holding the paddle. Wait, what is this pattern that you're uncovering?
I don't know. I think we've seen enough of this game, though. It's just Arkanoid on a bigger screen. There. It's what it is.
I mean, it's no DX ball.
Yeah. There are way better Arkanoids.
Such Arkanoid?
No pinball, and that's it's no
pinball.
Pinball.
I meant slot it.
Not pinball, okay. But yeah.
It's like, what sort of weird ass boring pinball games are you playing?
Oh, Bill's gonna play it anyway, just spite me.
Well,
get that $100 jackpot, Bill.
This is literally the most basic jackpot ever.
What was that, Jerry?
No. But back when this came out, this probably had all the bells and whistles and...
But it has a bell.
Apparently getting 3 apples in a row is nothing.
Apparently that was something. Just bell.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I think we're done.
2.
Oh hey, it's numbers game from Koei. Nope. But
better not play that. You might get brain stroke. Might cop DMCA. Hey, it's...
That's an ancient shooter.
It's a Galaga like Galaxy.
Helpful. So that's unworkable because it doesn't work in the current version of DOSBox, apparently.
So that was basically a big paragraph saying the game has a bug in it?
Yeah. Well, it's a DOS.
Oh, look what it is.
Oh.
okay. Oh, hey, it's another breakout clone. It's playable. We've seen worse.
That has a really satisfying sound.
Do you feel we need to see more of this, or are we done with this?
You're the one. You tell us.
I think we've seen enough of this first.
Okay.
Just break out.
I don't know. Maybe something happens when you beat stage 100.
Maybe you get like a special
bar pick. Games. How is this sports?
What? Price that had a cover. Accolade, what are you doing? You're drunk. You went to the bar too late.
Four
games. Yeah, that sound of rolling the dice is great.
Let me guess, is this something like...
So is this something you could always ask the bartender to do?
Hey, I think there might be a tell here. I think there might be a slight tell for her hand.
Hey, it's cheating that you're a psychic build.
No.
Emily lost, it's... apparently.
Oh, I guess it wasn't that good of a tale after all.
Oh, psychic gambling.
Also, how do you have
Useless
a hand
psychic with... powers?
How do you have a hand with dice?
Who the fuck knows?
At the old saloon.
We're having more tells. I think this is like that. I vaguely recall this like a game that was being played on like. If you remember the game, it was in Pirates of the Caribbean that I think is this.
There's some.
Because if you remember, there was like liars shit, and you have to bet things and call them and whatever.
Liars dice or something? Yeah.
Psychically bluffing.
Except some of her mind.
Dang, I have a terrible hand. Haha, I fooled you.
You shouldn't tell me that you don't have that many twos!
That must mean she does have that many.
Maybe.
Don't tell me! That's the problem with that one is there wasn't even a psychic. She literally said that to us!
Maybe she's lying.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, we're selecting a next contestant for something else. We're going to be doing something with Cherry.
Or Chuck Norris.
The next contestant.
What the fuck are we, there's a thing to tip water on them? What the fuck?
I am...
What the fuck is going on?
Is this some sort of... Also, why is the guy...
I think you're like washing away their clothes or something.
What's so like a... Oh, you are.
Because that's how clothes work, you know.
Yeah,
yes.
Dissolve in water.
Clothes are made of water.
Tissue paper.
Bunch of points for soaking them. Okay. There doesn't seem to be any actual porn.
Yeah, I don't think you got good far enough.
I don't think you could, son. I think the most you might get is seeing some nipples being hard or something. I don't think you'd see anything more than that.
But you did miss a lot.
Are we the bartender now? What?
Maybe we were always the bartender. The real bartender is in you.
Ah. Okay, I think we're done with this. There's a bunch of really shitty games. There's apparently 5 games total. Which include Last Call. I wish I could read what the fuck this was saying, but it is too small. Okay, you're a bartender in that one, and you need to feed or give people drinks. Another one is you have to be a pickup artist. And another one is air hockey. Great. Barbarian.
Barbarians, okay, where you also Barbie play a bartender. Oh. Oh, we gotta play them all.
There's only 2.
You bar all the
barbarians. Oh, that.
Barbarian.
Oh, graphics, and we had some voice acting.
Bay 52.
You joke.
I heard it.
Now, how does this work? Okay, I think.
Cursor. What? Wait, you control him with the mouse?
No.
I'm confused. Pulsating monster with a sword.
It's basically impossible to actually do anything.
Well, this game's terrible.
Absolute trash. This has been a really shitty night for games.
Oh, this is just the NES game.
Who knows? Can we have at least one game that's vaguely tolerable?
Hey, yeah, Baldi, but
that was pretty garbage because it made no
sense.
You have
to suffer for the one night you had multiple good games spelled.
Loading Barbie's Dream.
Oh, check out this jump animation.
But she's made of plastic. What do you expect? Barbie is like fashion to be, you know, have a fashion model anatomy. Or based
how do
on
I get
how artists would draw a certain figure to make clothes look good, and the whole idea was let's make that into a doll so people can enjoy dressing.
Is this an attack? What am I doing? Why am I throwing heart?
You're throwing your heart out.
I mean, Barbie was never really meant to be, say, a doll model.
You're throwing your heart away and then retrieving it.
I think if you throw it at the bird, you can get the bird to do stuff for you, like boxes. I vaguely recall you can control the animals.
Do I have to do it a bunch of times?
I think you can swap.
Yeah, this is exactly the NES version.
I think you can swap between some things. Like
if I could figure out how.
Can you duck and do it?
No.
So it looks like it's disappearing before it hits the guy.
Well, I was able to. It is actually hitting him, I think.
Like, maybe I think it's the Koopa thinks it's the diamond.
Yeah, sure, but how do I switch to the diamond?
I don't know, enter?
No.
You switched earlier at the start.
Did I?
Yes.
Yeah, you went all the way to the heart. Wait, the start. Whatever button you were pushing.
Don't think I hit any button.
Is it shift?
Left, right?
Okay, it's space.
Oh. Try the diamond.
Okay, I can walk on that.
Ah, the bird turns into a platform. You know, like real bird. Tennis! Uh-oh!
I did great, apparently. And I'm loading now. Okay. Shockingly, this is one of the most tolerable games this entire night.
I mean, on the NES, it got the Nintendo seal of approval.
Oh yeah, that was really worth it.
All the pink teddy bears.
Diamond.
Okay, that's a way of getting down here, I suppose.
Birds and bears.
Get me onto the bird game.
Look out, Barbie, you might wake up.
Bird's the word. Kitty! Aubrey's taking those balls like a champ.
Uh-oh! Gadios! Oops!
Why do beach balls want to murder Barbie anyway?
I think if you keep doing it, the cat will close the beach ball spawner. Yeah.
Hmm.
Oh, but I think you lost.
I think we've seen enough of this. It's vaguely playable compared to a lot of other games.
You can never have enough of Barbie.
I mean, as I said, it's compared to the other trash, it actually made some sense.
I mean, this makes more sense being on DOS since you have this or Balloon Fight. Balloon with a Z. Ball Buster.
Oh boy.
We got music this time. I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world.
Camera goes to makeup room, shopping bag, dressing room, and this other thing. Oh, we're driving.
Oh, is this the one we make Barbie crunch into people? This is the SNES Barbie game now. Bam! Oh, I love the sound effect. Barbie and although that is some nice music. Driving.
Okay, now I have to match Barbie with the magazine cover, apparently.
Yeah, he's wearing like a...
Whoa, she slides around the room like she's fucking possessed.
Well, she's a plastic doll! Oh my god, come on, game! Give me the outfit!
Can there, you remember?
Yeah, there
the
we
one
go.
With the one with the animal. It's the one with the friend from Scooby-Doo ascot. Except she was wearing blue jeans, I thought.
Eh, see, I got at least some points, so it probably was at least close enough. Given how I had to continuously scroll through the things, I wasn't really going to fuck around.
I think in the SNES one, you actually cycled through each one individually of how they're going off screen. Like, you just click on a tech,
well,
press the button.
That's not how it works here.
Barbie warring over everyone in her giant Corvette. Sold separately. Troll. We gotta remember this for later. Control, down. Control, left.
Control, down. Control, left. Alt, up. Alt, up. Control, down.
This is runway practice?
So she's kind of dancing.
I think it does get harder. I mean, this is what Barbie is.
Do I need to do something to get out of this? Okay, I need to hit enter, apparently.
Do you remember the four important key presses? Control,
no.
Control, Alt, Alt?
No. Now
you have to drive back to the studio.
That surfer is drunk.
At least you don't have to catch ghosts driving. Like another game.
Match Barbie with magazine cover again.
Blue hat, stars.
That wasn't what I wanted to do. I didn't want to just leave that. I wanted to actually try and match it, but apparently hitting enter is not how you select the thing to modify.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I think I managed to remember the thing. Hooray.
Success! Barbie did it. I think there's more stuff in those. Now Barbie's dreaming about being at the beach while the...
She dreams about skating on the beach, I guess. Okay, let's try and do fashion again. So she's wearing a pink bikini and black shoes, apparently.
Better than California. Death.
It's been just slightly repetitive.
That was the same warning. Hey! That was the right one!
No, it was a pink bikini. But it was a different shape of pink bikini is the thing.
Oh.
We're looking for the right shape of pink bikini. Like it is. I don't even know where.
Like, can you adjust when it's the right type of outfit? Can you adjust?
I don't know. It doesn't look like it. There we go, I found it. Yay, I matched it perfectly. Yay.
Oh, it wasn't a bikini top, it was a halt. My bad.
It's alt, down, shift, left, alt, up, and shift, up. So alt, shift, alt, shift. About actually registering key presses too.
Was this the demo they pitched DDR?
I don't think there's any rhythm involved. Okay, this thing again, and hopefully this time I can actually do it. This has got a pink eyes, pink lipstick, ears, earrings.
Okay. Purple eyeliner, purple lipstick.
Oh, space also leaves it, so I have no idea how to I still have no idea how to interact in that game other than just immediately leaving it. I have still yet to actually manage to figure out how to interact in that game. Enter leaves it immediately. Space leaves it immediately. There don't seem to be any other buttons.
We customize our Barbie.
This is again one of the most playable games in this entire thing.
When you don't skip past the puzzle. Those are just mini. This was all a dream Barbie was having, so it doesn't really matter. now she's writing about it in her diary.
Oh, we don't want to hit the ice.
Usually, that's how it happens. Now she's off.
So, Alt.
Oh, we already at the end?
Shift. Alt, shift. How many levels there are of this.
I don't.
It's at least 4. Now we're on a bicycle. Which is clearly bullshit because it requires legs to expand.
There wasn't any thought bubbles coming from her head. Was she imagining this or?
I don't know.
Come on, game. You have to be consistent. What is the nature of Barbie's reality?
Okay, we're in that dress. Now, if I can figure out how to get to that dress.
Okay. The nightgown, the night owl dress, or the ball gown, I guess.
It's similar to this outfit, but a different color. Does going up or down?
Yes.
Alter it? No.
Yeah, it wasn't the blue one, it's like beige. Kind of a golden pink one.
This is absolutely amazingly irritating because I have no idea what the buttons are doing.
Surprised they programmed that thing enough.
There aren't actually that many outfits, they're just different colors of the same relatively small selection of outfits.
Still wasn't the right color.
Okay, let's try the up arrows and see if those do anything. There we go, found it. Okay, shift, control, alt.
Sounds like a Barbie game that has nothing to do with actual Barbie, like Barbie Sim City or something.
Eyeshadow, orangish lipstick, hoop earrings, and a black hat. Okay, it's Control that can do things.
Oh, Control.
Okay. There we go.
Top hat.
I didn't even pay attention to what her...
Blue.
What her nails were.
Oh shoot, I didn't know this hurt.
There we go, there's the hair. There, I think that's most of the things. Oh, hey, I just randomly happened to get the correct nail color without even noticing it. So I think I got that perfect just by accident. Game over. We're done, I guess.
You are win?
It looks like it.
SNES, $50.
Oh, Jesus Christ. That was honestly one of the best things of the night, sadly.
Is this one of the first ones you've completed?
One of them, yeah.
Bard's Tale. Instruction set. What?
I guess you designed the pits.
Oh, so it's Dungeon Maker?
Yeah, we're gonna skip that one. Interestingly, we do not have regular Bard's Tale. We have Bard's Tale 2, which looks like trash. And Bard's Tale 3, which also looks pretty shit.
I want to see Bargain Attack.
Okay. Basically, so by the way, Bard's Tale 2 and 3 are dungeon crawlers. Don't bother playing any of them.
Oh.
They're all crap. Play Legend of Grimrock or Legend of Grimrock 2 if you want that gameplay and actually good. Anything else is going to be pretty shit.
Oh, this is an adventure game. Never mind. I guess.
Let's see what it looks like at least.
Looks better than the bat one.
At this time, I was living in Paris, facing the Eiffel Tower. The River Seine is flowing very near. The Champs-Élysées Avenue is not very far.
It has used ScumVM, which means it is full screen, and it is also fucking up my screen resolution. There we go, I've gotten it out.
As far as I'm concerned, I was living more on the east side. From my bedroom, I could see Montmartre. The sight was great, but I could not take advantage of it. I spent all my time playing Bargain Attack. Suddenly, everyone had become crazy with that game. The Bargamanian had spread like wildfire. But some people disappeared. Every day, without being noticed. A few persons had raised the alarm, but they had been murdered.
What?
That was the story. I'm just trying to get my other windows onto the correct screen, because they've all been...
What could have run a bell to us earthworms was the name of the firm which had published Bargain Attack. It was called Invaders. The Invaders?
Yeah! I won!
All the thunder.
You're a hacker.
All the thunder.
That was a complete surprise. Dazzling attack. Within a few hours, the earth was turned into blood and fire. The Bargonian hordes were marching, slaughtering, mutilating the population. Then, in order to perfect their task, the Bargonians disintegrated the earth! Fortunately, I, Bob Sprite, was already on Bargain to catch up with him.
Apparently, the main character of the game was already on the planet Bargain, so he wasn't killed when they disintegrated the earth.
The nightmare becomes reality. I feel like this should be voice too.
You would think that. What the fuck?
This. Okay, Kaneko man.
Oh.
What?
Nope, hit the power button on screen.
Apparently.
Nope, didn't do it in. I think you had to click on your little.
You've lost, Earthlink.
Oh, never mind.
What the fuck is going on?
Are you actually controlling him right now?
I don't know.
Did you manage to sell your penis on the black market, Archlon?
Okay, I think it went.
At this time,
demo.
I was living in Paris, facing the Eiffel Tower.
You did lose.
No, I think it went into demo when I started.
Ow. Yeah, here's clearly the real part of the game because it has copy protection.
Yeah, this game seems to play fine. We will probably come back to this nonsense.
Okay.
It's another adventure game. So it goes onto the list of adventure games that will be done in hell garbage stream. Oh, hey, Zeta's here. Get into the stream, Zeta. Barney Splat. Oh, what the fuck
is this? I've actually seen this one. I think I had a shareware CD. Oh wait, no. The one I saw actually had graphics. This looks like it's a text adventure.
Damn, bug flying around my face.
I'm regretting having selected the sound familiarization test. Are you still going on with this fucking test?
It's the Barney song. The thing that my dad used to
know. The problem is that you can't get out of it! Okay, I'm closing it because it won't stop doing the fucking sound test.
Well, Belle, did you familiarize yourself with the sound after all that?
It apparently crashed?
Oh, that was terrible. Oh, go try it one more time.
It looks like it crashes regardless of which one I select. Okay, whatever.
Good game.
Baron Baldrick.
It's like a Spyro game.
Okay, left and right attack. Scoop what?
Amiga! Oh, that crazy old Baron.
I don't want to use the... Oh.
This is your life now.
I'm trying to figure out what the fire key is. And yes, he flashes his ass at us.
The
screen agent is fucked up a bit. We're not gonna be playing this for long, so I don't care that much.
Oh, we aren't?
Where the fuck is the mouse?
We're not going 100% to this Baron Baldrick?
No.
Although, as far as I know, the game could just be called Baron Ball.
It's pretty much unplayable because I can't figure out how to even get to the first area because it's being so bad.
I just ran the 10 things into the
So, seriously, what is the player supposed to do here?
It's a puzzle game.
Sure, fun, great puzzle. Just literally unsurmountable puzzle that the player can do nothing with.
You have a bar that's...
I don't care. Whatever this fuck garbage trash is, it can go the hell away and never show up again. Oh, Jesus Christ. So many shit games tonight. We've seen nothing that's actually good.
Look at that 206 color.
What the fuck is happening?
Ouch, smoke.
All the
I kind of suck smoke. I thought it was bad for me in my like 10 hours on average.
What the fuck?
You stop and think something's wrong.
Can you stop time?
Are you sure?
Yo, can you stop the? That's can you stop time?
Ooh, what button Barracuda. Game?
Nope. You didn't stop.
It's like literally any button that is any input makes it restart this fucking terrible intro screen.
UA is drunk.
Welp.
Oh, Jesus. It finally... So you literally cannot do anything other than you have to wait for it to leave that thing. Because game design...
Seizure!
Get used to that.
Take that mission one!
Read instructions. Okay, space fires... Be sure to pick up anything you can.
Pick.
P picks things up, D drops them. Okay.
It's already trolls. What? Helicopter?
I don't know.
Map? Tornadoes? What is this?
I don't know. More unplayable trash, I guess. Yeah, I don't understand how to make it do anything. Maybe escape. Well, escape left it. Okay, game. That was garbage. Yet another layer of inscrutable garbage trash. Oh, hey, a shooter game. This might actually be a playable game with controls that make sense.
Hey, a shmup.
So then he looks at an actual non-trash. Do we want to be red or blue?
Blue.
Okay, sure. Okay, alt shoot. Okay, I see how to play now. I have to actually manage, if I can manage to not get hit by everything. Long enough to actually start getting power ups. Okay. We're in business. Ah, damn it. I'm not very good at dodging things.
Oh, it's wrong.
Okay, I've at least figured out how to play. So let's try this again with less dying at the start, now that I've figured out what the buttons to shoot are. But this seems like a tolerable game. So this is probably the winner of the night just by virtue of the fact that it is not any of the other trash.
It is playable.
Doesn't have the word
wins.
Hey, Bell, are you got here?
Looks like it took more than a weekend to program. It wins.
I want both of your hero.
Mouse.
If I can figure out how to... There we go. I figured out pause button. You are seeing the whole thing, but that's the best I got. Okay, I've got lasers, apparently. Ah, damn it. These projectiles in this game are... Your ship is very far.
Big diamond.
A lot of these scrolling shooters have problems when they make your craft too big in relation to everything else on the screen.
Yeah, this is extremely large, it feels like.
Are any enemies already?
Excuse me.
At least it looks enjoyable.
Oh, it's definitely a million times better than all the other crafts. It's at least as a playable and comprehensible actual UI that is useful. It would just be real nice if it was possible to actually, you know, not die every 2 seconds. Let's try the other ship and see if it's got any difference.
With that one glaring issue aside, it seems fun.
So it's like, it's really difficult to not get hit by that, by these basic ships, or by literally every single thing on the screen, because your ship is so fucking huge. And the projectiles are so close together.
don't forget you have a bomb.
Yeah, well, the bomb is limited use. That's the super bomb. Okay, this is a decent weapon at least. It would also help if I had save states, but of course I don't have
them. How about DOS simulators compared to what it is?
Not that I've found the active work.
I mean, you could have artificially with, if you're a virtual machine and running DOSBox in a virtual machine.
That would be far too much effort to do. You do seem to not lose all of your power-ups when you die.
That's generous.
It's literally impossible to survive.
Yeah, it's literally impossible to actually avoid the shot most of the time. So yeah, interest far more playable than most of them, but effectively impossible to actually do. The Basket Manager. Sports and basketball. Basket playoff. No. Bass class. The basics of bass fishing. Nope. Bat ball. At least this looks like a thing which isn't a sports or a fishing game. Cursor keys cannot be used!
Koopo, if you want to find stupid and bad and disturbing things on the internet, it's not that difficult or unheard of to find them.
Oh, what the fuck? What the fuck is this?
Oh, it's,
I am controlling green. That is the only one I have control of.
What is that thing called?
It seems interesting.
I suppose it also seems like it's incredibly difficult to actually do. Okay, the AI is not that good. I thought the AI was far better than it actually is.
Oh, and they increase the difficulty as each player is eliminated.
Yeah.
Neat.
Some actual good design!
I would say tolerable design. Good is pushing.
Well, good in comparison to everything else that's typically
not
showing
a
up.
High bar. Okay, we've seen a stage. They all seem to be the same. That is far more playable than anything else we've seen so far. Oh, Jesus. Batman Forever.
Oh, no. And then Batman Forever, the arcade game, Batman Returns, The Crusader, the movie.
Batman the Crusader, Batman the Arena, and Battle Arena to Shinden. Okay.
Still waiting for it to finish extracting the image file. How many... Oh, Jesus, there's a million BA games, aren't there? Of course there are. I guess we can go until we reach the word bat, and then I am going to stop doing this. Because...
Oh, all of the battles.
Game activated.
Yeah, as soon as we get past bat and into battle, I'm stopping there. By Acclaim, so this is at least made by an actual game development company, which makes it already...
Not a very good one.
Million times better than slow fucking software.
That's like saying this piece of shit is better than this wet piece of shit.
Well, it is! Yes, I know there is flickering.
I do believe their claim was the ones responsible for the console. This, I believe, would be the same as what they had on the Sega CD.
Such a subtle secret button. No one would ever notice this secret button.
Press it on X.
Yep. Oh, Jesus, the run-in cycle. Oh, man. That's how people run. That's how legs work.
I like how those tires have to...
I mean, they're on model with the movie so far.
If it was the bat ass and bat nipples.
I don't know about that yet. One. Okay. Now it's into the actual game menu. Good. The game menu is a different size.
Weapon selected.
Stop. Select zero. Jiggly Batman.
Alright, good job. I mean, we're gonna have the problem that I have no idea what any of the buttons are.
Remember, I won't be here tomorrow.
Okay, we're gonna escape and see if I can actually get it to let me define the key.
I think I'm gonna jump out here. Getting tired. So, night, guys.
Okay, let's look it up. Okay. No, I don't want the Game Boy and Game Gear controls. Not Super Nintendo. Okay, here we go. Keyboard controls, left, right, up, down. Up and left or right for some sort of flip. Okay, fighting controls are... What the fuck? Block is 5 on the keypad. Low punch is N. Oh, I see. They are using the numpad.
Yeah, I was gonna say that sounds like a numpad setup.
Select weapons. Weapons selected.
Stop the riot.
So, let's see. Roundhouse. Okay, there's a roundhouse kick. So, grappling hook. Which one do you insert? Okay, that's the grappling hook at this 45 degree angle. Very slight delay if you want. Okay, we have another dude. We just beat up Ned. Whoever the fuck Ned is.
Ned's dead. Oh, those are lights. I was wondering what the fuck was with that red thing. Secrets be
led. If they aren't already,
it's supposed to be like that spinning light.
Okay, Riddler. Okay, game. What is the there in space? I mean, this is vaguely playable so far. What is the cape glide? Up while jumping, okay. Okay, simple enough. Do I need to do anything here? Let's try beer. I broke that. That was pretty amazing. He went Berserker Rage tonight.
Berserker Burn.
To discover the treasures revealing their jewels, open their locks with your world of tools. Again, and you'll get it too.
What the fuck is this thing supposed to be? Is that, like, supposed to be a window? What is this? What is this layering?
Oh.
drop into is complete and down.
Of course it is.
Well, that is basically it's on the numpad, so it's actually relatively close to each other. Still can't figure out how to roll. I managed it once accidentally, and I've never managed again. We're gonna be done with this soon. Okay, we're done with him.
Almost looks like it's running too fast.
Maybe.
But it might just be crappy animation.
I think it's just shitty animation. It seems to be your character movement seems to be relatively sensible. I can't figure out how to get any farther here, so I think we're done. We've seen that one. It's tolerable. If you really want to tolerate it. It's not good, but it's playable-ish. I've seen worse tonight. Which is not saying much, but we have seen worse. Let's see if this is more playable.
Batman Forever, the arcade game. Which, from the screenshot, looks like it's a basic brawler.
Yeah.
Maybe a fighting game.
It should be. No, it says it's a beat 'em up. Okay. Left. Right. Up. Down. Little spinny. Skipping calibration for joystick 2. Winners don't use drugs, guys.
So like the Gravity Falls parody of that. Winners don't lose. This is what they should have brought to the
Why did they bother playing any of the other ones? Or putting them on?
Because some people bought licenses and then I guess for this. I'm trying to think of how to do a very high pitched gravelly voice and then just end it.
Hi, I'm Batman!
I think I'm also terrible at beat 'em ups, so I think we've seen enough of this.
You're terrible at a lot of games.
I never claimed to be good at beat 'em ups.
Has it been a game based on any DC property or Batman since Arkham Knight back in 2015?
Probably.
But yeah, that's way better than the other Batman game. Okay, this is probably actually playable. It's because this is an adventure game, apparently. So it may actually
Batman Returns the adventure game. Oh, good. Point and click.
Well, it's got subgenres fighting.
By Konami.
Yeah.
Let's wait for somebody to parrot it. Oh, yeah.
If it is, then I'm deleting it again.
We need a Batman Pachinko machine.
Okay, this is clearly not being emulated right, because I'm pretty sure this is not
what it's intended to do. Oh, just remember, how am I going to stream the Persona 3 Pachinko machine?
I don't know. Okay, it's literally a point and click adventure game. Which means it is probably light years better than. Yeah, this looks playable. It that's yet another into the line of adventure games that will be done.
My bad computer. Playing at missile command there. Somebody's dog does not like.
Okay. Batman, the Cape Crusader. Jesus. Batman, the Cape Crusader from 1988. This is gonna suck.
I remember this.
Oh, a Data East game. Yeah, that is.
I remember this from the AVGN video. It's, yeah.
Is that the one with the Joker always laughing or a different one? Goddamn, Mike Matei's Joker was annoying.
Oh.
Well, I think it was part one, so not that one.
What?
I have gastric distress.
Just took you outside. Insert the disc.
No idea what I'm doing.
The city sleeps.
Oh, hey. That guy was apparently an enemy.
He's carrying a gun around.
I thought it was a walking stick for a while. What? Huh? What?
Playmaker.
I think I just dropped the banana. I think that's what I just did. No. Okay, so there's the banana.
That for scale.
Okay, there we go. I got it up again.
And then make a pill for that.
Okay, I think I ate it. Why, but I think I ate
it. Skills of potassium.
Are these supposed to be a threat? By the way, the music is great. Not a super annoying, incredibly short fucking loop of trash. Punching this guy is really awkward to do, by the way, because there isn't a punch button. You have to be hitting forward and attack at the same time to punch. What yes. even is this?
Clearly, game? There were not enough keys on DOS computers to dedicate a single button to punch.
Oh, thank God I can turn off the music. Ugh, that is honestly better. Shoes. I got shoes now.
I'm Batman.
I have 3%.
Very red
criminal scum has feet.
No, I think I put on the shoes?
Criminals be stunned by my sick kicks.
This game is awful.
Astonishingly playable for how awful it is, I will say. I mean, it is atrocious, but it is almost playable. Oh, I think so. I think that they're dropping like chips or something that I can eat to like heal up a little bit.
That's gotta why. Have my battery. Gotta have my Doritos.
Basically. Oh, hey, another enemy. Fuck it. Well, let's see. Let's go up. If I can figure out how... Come on. Go up. There we go. Got him. Come on, down! Jesus Christ. It's impossible to duck when you want to duck. I got a lightsaber, apparently. For being enemies, they're really not very aggressive. And you don't really even kill them at all. You just, or you know, knock them out or anything. You just punch them enough and then they drop their chips and walk away. It's like, here, Batman, take my Doritos.
Please don't hurt me. Have my cool wrench.
There we go, see?
Just stop, dude. Give you the food, okay? Just leave me alone. I don't like being punched.
I demand ruffles of justice.
I better take out this guy too for the hell. Assuming I can get him to ever line up with my punches. Cause the punch timing is really irritating. Okay, I got him. Come on, pick up the food. There we go, I'm mostly at full health. Oh, I can just leave the screen and come back and another one will show up. So there's one of these dudes on basically every single screen.
So you got infinite punching bags of these guys.
God, crouch! It is absolutely obnoxious as fuck to try and get your character to crouch.
But this game looks so good.
Yeah, you have to be hitting forward at the same time as you hit down, because otherwise you will just face towards the camera.
They didn't really think through the controls, did they?
I think we've seen about enough of this crap. Finally, Batman the movie. This is the last Batman game that we seem to have here.
Batman, the movie, the game, the movie.
Oops, I started the other one again by accident. Four.
Oh, not the 1960s movie.
Okay, one.
Someday you should just can't get rid of a bomb.
Okay, we're gonna have to try and set a two joystick. Maybe the joystick will be at least a little bit more coherent.
You need out? On the outside?
Okay, I can move now. So this, I think, if I can get up, I think those are supposed to be batarangs that I'm throwing there. Oh, that's my extendo penis. You'll see in a second.
Yeah, I've got one of those too.
This literally looks like an extendo. Oh, whoa, like holy shit. Dick.
I want you to tell all your friends.
The world's longest erection.
Wow, the controls are. Oh. Holy shit. The penis controls are not the greatest.
Batman like does not have great control over his facility.
I can't figure out how to get it. Maybe I have to hit like up. There we
no,
go.
It looks more like the world's like most straight pee stream. Because it looks yellowish, doesn't it?
Yeah, but it's clearly not a pee stream because it sticks to walls and he can climb up it.
No, he's just water bending it.
Oh, I see.
You know, that'd be something that you'd see in, like, the adult parody of the Avatar. The Legend of Avatar.
Also, there's a big problem with this game, which is that the calibration has not worked quite right. So, if I don't enter any controls, I wander slowly to the left. I think we've seen about enough of that penis game.
And time is up.
Okay, we are now...
Oh, never mind. I misread that. That was an 8.
Yes.
Battle Arena Toshinden?
Well, that'll be for next time. Ugh, that was an amazingly terrible selection of games tonight. Every single one was garbage. How long until we get to Descent? So at least that's a good game. That I know how to play. And it has sensible controls. And we got a long way to go before we get good games. At least we got a whole bunch of Descents. We got Descent 2, we got Descent 2 Vertigo, we got Descent Anniversary Edition. Yeah, we got through all those pieces of shit, but we got a lot more pieces of shit to go, Koopo. We have a lot of trash.
He's trying to be Mr. Brightside.
Descent is a really good game, so when we get there... Oh, we also got Battletech, which I will probably just replace with the modern Battletech. And say, no, this is what Battletech is supposed to be. This is trash.
You gotta at least play a bit of it.
Fine, we will see. We here we go. We can see the map. It looks like shit. We're done.
Side by side. Do side by side.
Then, now.
This looks like Super Robot Wars, but really shit. I mean, look at this face in the back. Look at that fucking face. Emotive out. I swear they did actually make this out of a Super Robot Wars game or something. Because emotive outtakes in the Japanese comic style increase the realism. How exactly does that increase the realism? Oh, Jesus. At least I know enough about BattleTech that I will be able to recognize pretty much all of what the weapons do, so I won't actually need the mech or weapon tech with the weapon recognition guy, because I at least remember most of the things. So that's one bright spot. Out of curiosity, actually, I'm going to go down to the M's. See if we've got any mech warrior games. Yes, we do. We have Mech Warrior, the original, and we have Mech Warrior 2 Limited Edition and Mech Warrior 2 Mercenary. They are iffy. I may replace those with MechWarrior 4 Mercenaries instead, because I know that game is significantly less shitty. But we will see. Oh, hey! If you thought the appearance of the BattleTech games was bad, there's Mech Brigade! Look at these graphics! Are those your units? What even are those things?
Conway's game of Square Combat. Cells?
I guess they're supposed to be like icons for tanks. Oh, Jesus. I'm gonna go back and find the one we were on. The fuck is this shit? Doom 2D. Oh, that'll be great. All of the Doom games will be replayed, will probably be done in a modern source port, because why the fuck would I want to play the original? And I can play something where people have actually remade it. I might also throw in the modern Doom as well, somewhere in there. Because that's a really fun game. Did I see Bomberman in there? Yes, there is a Bomberman as well. Which is probably actually going to be tolerable. Because Bomberman is usually playable. You can't... I would say you can't fuck it up too hard, but we have seen a person fuck it up really hard. Because they made it 3D in this collection, and it was atrocious. Because it wasn't just 3D, it was 3D in first person.
Huh? Yes. Bomberman supposed to be third person?
It's supposed to be a top-down thing, or at least a third-person game, but no, I don't remember which one it was. It was somewhere in the A's.
Hey, what Bomberman? What?
A 3D bomber. This was it.
Oh.
First-person Bomberman.
Yeah, also Bomberman X Zero on 360 did the same thing.
I don't think it did it like this.
It was first person.
Not with literally. Like the thing is, though, this was literally the original Bomberman style of gameplay directly turned into first person mode. There was no minimap.
That's exactly
or anything.
That's exactly what X Zero did. They just turned the game into
first
person.
I'm pretty sure X Zero did it competently. This did not.
No, that game's a piece of shit.
Not as shitty as this one. I can tell you right now. Game. You did not see this shittiness. This is way shittier. Act-Zero is way worse than is way better than this thing. It would be hard to be worse.
Pick up that game.
And yeah, that is more than enough trash. Somebody else should stream something.